Hello, welcome to Gallery 21, the Mausoleum at Halikarnassos. My name is Peter Higgs, one of the curators in the Department of Greece and Rome. This gigantic tomb, built for King Mausolus, who reigned between 377 to 353 BC, was the ultimate status symbol and one of the seven wonders of the ancient world. Mausolus was a powerful governor in the Persian Empire, ruling over an important province with his capital at Halikarnassos, modern-day Bodrum, in southwest Turkey. The Greek writer Lucian imagines the king as he looks up at his monument. I have lying over me a vast memorial, outdoing that of any other of the dead, not only in size, but also in its finished beauty, with horses and men reproduced most perfectly in the fairest marble. It would be difficult to find even a temple like it. Ancient accounts and the surviving remains of the mausoleum support Lucian's description of the magnificent monument. Mausolus was a great admirer of Greek culture. He founded new cities across his kingdom, and he planned his own tomb so that it would dominate Halikarnassos and even be visible from out at sea. It was about 45 metres high and was decorated with elaborate statues and carved friezes. No expense was spared. Famous Greek architects and sculptors were brought in, working with the finest imported marble. When Mausolus died, his wife, who was also his sister, Artemisia, completed the building of the tomb. The building survived until a series of earthquakes toppled it. It was then used by the Knights of St. John, who were fortifying their castle, which still stands at the harbour of Bodrum today. The site of the tomb then disappeared from view until Charles Newton, a British archaeologist and diplomat, rediscovered the site in 1856 and transported what he found back to London with the Sultan of Turkey's permission. Now, stand in front of the colossal horse with its original bronze bridle and bit. It was one of four horses that pulled a chariot placed on top of the pyramid roof, each painted a different colour. Next to it is a lion, one of perhaps 90 that patrolled the base of the pyramid steps, protecting the spirit of the dead king. And look at the two colossal portrait statues, the male one a handsome and powerful interpretation of a Carian ruler. His long hair, short beard and upper body tunic are all characteristics that betray his non-Greek origin. His female companion might be a member of the cosmopolitan Carian court or one of the female ancestors of Mausolus. The exact position of all the sculptures on the building is uncertain, but they reflect scenes that were typical of dynastic tombs in the 4th century BC. The carved friezes that flank the room show graphic details of legendary battles between Greeks and Amazons and centaurs and Lapiths, their design reflecting the very latest fashions in Greek sculpture. Look closely on some of the frieze blocks for traces of actual colour that once covered the sculpture. Because of its vast scale and the superb quality of its sculptures, it's no wonder that Mausolus's tomb was listed as one of the seven wonders of the ancient world. It gave the term mausoleum to all subsequent monumental tombs.